Hi everyone, Dorda Kitty here. It's been a while since we last had a preview update. Don't get me wrong, we're still releasing a bunch of patches to the 2020.3 LTS, but shouldn't there be at least a 2021.1 at this point? Well, FlightGear is going through a pretty deep architectural overhaul. The devs have been working on new rendering and scenery frameworks that use more up-to-date graphics programming methods, and laid the groundwork for upcoming new enhancements, like shadows and a PBR-based rendering system. What this means for us users, though, is that it would probably be the end of 2021 or later until the next preview release comes out, and I'll have almost nothing flashy to show in the release video. But that doesn't mean that there aren't any quality of life updates either. For instance, and this is what I want to talk about today, the rendering options dialog has been reorganized again. Take a look. The settings that are still here are the ones that shouldn't change the frame rate much, with some notable exceptions. The rest of the settings are now controlled by these presets here. There are 5 of them, and they range from everything off for the potatoes up there, to everything on for people who were lucky enough to have a top-of-the-line graphics card installed in early 2021. For those like me that like to have a bit more control over what exactly gets displayed and what doesn't, I'm glad to say that all of the old options and more are still accessible by selecting the custom preset. Up here is where you can switch ALS on and off. This area might later become useless though, because I've heard that there are plans to phase out being able to disable ALS. Time will tell if they're actually going to go through with this, but if your computer is already struggling to run FlightGear 2020.3 with minimal graphics settings, you might want to keep your old install around when a new version comes out. This is where you change the quality level of the shaders, similar to the sliders in previous versions. On my computer, the first 5 don't have much of an impact on performance, but overlay is a big hulking framerate eater. Your computer might be different though. This is where you tell FlightGear which things you want to see out the window. You can also still turn on and off OpenStreetMap objects, including realistic roads, pylons, and dense buildings here. Pylons have a pretty big performance impact, and buildings don't really have much as long as you're seeing them from far away. We also got a new section where you can change the resolution of the shadows and limit the number of lights in the scene, which is great because I want to see those beautiful shadows, but the fixed shadow resolution in the older versions really tanked the frame rate. It should be noted that the ALS filter settings have now been moved to its own menu item. I like to set it to about here. That's all I'm going to cover today. I've just got FG Camera working on my computer, and I'll try to figure out how to demonstrate it in the next video. Thanks for watching Dorda Kitty, and I'll see you again in 2 weeks. Have a nice flight!